Okay, now I'm gonna try to do another unboxing video. I did some of these earlier to my channel, but I haven't done these in a long time. So let's see how another test is gonna go. So, hopefully the camera setup is really hard to put up in my house now, because I don't have any above camera kind of thing, so this is on the sideways on the table. But anyway, I got a new switch. So this is the brand new thing that I got. It's the Nintendo Switch OLED Pokemon Scarlet and Violet edition. And it's brand new, unopened, and I got it from myself. And this is the first Nintendo, brand new Nintendo console that I've ever owned. I last console that I had on the 90s were the Nintendo 8-bit NES and Super Nintendo SNES, but they were also, they were used, but anyway, I had them on the family and I didn't own them myself. So also I got this one as a brand new game. I'm a really big fan of karting games, and with this console you can play kartings in the split screen 4-player, and then you can also do a LAN play if you all have this console. So we have a plan to play this game probably in the 4-player mode, so that everybody has their own handheld. I got at least 4 people now that I got this console and this game. So we could try on talk show, try to maybe play 4-player mode on stream maybe, or something like that. That's one of the plans. So now that we got at least 4 of this, and it's this game, you have like, it says 48 tracks, but with the DLCs you can have like close to 100 tracks if you want some content more into this. And I'm using this unboxing table now that has all these Pokemons around here, and also Nintendo characters. Oh, this is a really big Nintendo fanboy. This is a you probably recognize this character. It's I'm not gonna say who it is, but it even has the taxi tag. It's also in this game, this karting game that I found. And then there's a Gengar, and then there's a Sylveon. Really like the pink or fairy and water. I'm kind of like mainly a fairy and water trainer. And there's a water. There's a shiny Vaporeon. So that's kind of like the sideway graphics that it fits to the theme now that I'm opening this. And let's see if I can. I have the camera set up into this really kind of sideways that I can't even see what's going on, unfortunately. Well, let's just open up the console first time ever. It's unopened, so let's see what does it look like. I don't even have a clue how to open this thing. But maybe this I think I'm using these gloves to look like a professional. But I really suck at this, and this is really amateur stuff right now, but I'm trying to show it on the camera also, about what can you expect from opening the box. But it seems like I have to break the box, because I don't know how to open this thing. And then you can open the thing like this, and it looks really cool. And this edition also, I really like the purple. Purple is kind of like my own team card. It's like the Spyro dragon form of Druid. And also this shiny Vaporeon water Pokemon also has the cool purple, but usually you don't have purple in this, so this has a special kind of coloring on the controllers. And I think this is supposed to be Scarlet. It's kind of like a orange red, so they have this Pokemon tags on them. So this look much better than the original things that don't have any prints. And this also, I think it also reminds me of a Halloween pumpkin, so that also fits into the camera, I mean not camera but channel themes of my channel. They're like really small and cute, so Yeah, you can get the, also you get the prints. Prints have the same kind of like. My hands are, by the way, really big. If you wonder how big this person is, they have this much better looking coloring. Originally, I think it only has this blank, stupid one color thing. So let's see. I have to kind of sideways try to check out what's going on. I might have to cut some parts out of this video if it gets to be. And also, I'm wearing this camo metal pantsu, or what are these even called? There's some kind of pro tip paper here. And seems to be a nice packaging. I'm gonna just throw it on the background. And then you get HDMI double. I don't know which version is it is. Is it like the newest something? 2.1, whatever it's called. I don't even know what the difference is. And then you got it's like the connection wire with the muuntaja. What is this even called? Adapter? I don't know. But at least it's not as big as the old school, you know, brick size thing of the what was it called? The joke meme that the Xbox 360 used to have, that insanely big adapter. And then you got this cool covering where you can put, I think you can put both of the controllers into this thing. This neat little thing, and then you can make this one big controller here. And yes, so there's some cool electronics parts, and hopefully I'm using a crappy cell phone to film these videos, because I don't have any better camera to use for this. I only have back there I got a internet camera or webcam, but it also does the same stupid things as this does. It's not a professional smart cam thing, but this you can make into one big controller with the two parts, or you can use the separate controllers to be so basically you also have the one good thing about this is that you can carry it to somebody's other's place, and then you can basically have two separate little controllers here straight away for two-player games. One more valuable thing to, yeah, that's the thing that you have to put into the controller to make it somehow function in the carryable mode, or whatever it's called, portable mode, yeah, something like that. And they both have their team colors in there, so you can have two controllers with one. So that's only one good reason why you get it. You buy one console and then you get two controllers straight away. PlayStation doesn't allow that. Other consoles don't have, usually they don't have anything like that. So it's a better deal with more value when you get more stuff with it. Now this has a like double double kind of cushion. And this also, yes, this is the reloading station, so it has this kind of like a really nice, it looks like some kind of Japanese, I don't know what it called, but the print is really nice. There you can see that it goes into that. This is like the dock station that allows you to reload it, I think, and it also, I think it allows you to connect it to the, I have never used this console myself, so I don't even know what I'm talking about. Sorry, but the printing is really cool. Now you really have this collections edition. Really nice looking. And let's see, does it have anything else in here? So far I don't see anything, so hopefully this doesn't require some kind of extra parts. So let's open up the Mario Kart. Hopefully you can just kind of like use the rusty Edward the Scissorhands garbage scissors to open up this thing. And then you just probably just rip it open like a crazy rabid dog or something. Some kind of furry creature on the druid form. And it's sealed, yes, so this is also brand new. And yes, also these are really small, but the funny thing is that the game itself is still even smaller. It's like this small SD card that you just stick into the control or the console. Yeah, so a really tiny thing that you just stick on the upper part of the console. But the cartridge, my English really sucks, by the way. So one thing that I'm using these voiceovers for, it's I'm trying to practice speaking out loud in English or Finglish or whatever this is. That's why I'm doing this testing videos. But you can see that this is my thumb, and this is how small it is. It's really small. But yeah, and also, yeah, it's a karting game. And one of the best reasons for this kind of console is the karting games. One other karting game that I was thinking about buying, but this is the CTR Nitro Fueled. So you can also play this on the 4-player split screen if you just stick this on the... You can use one console on the PC, I mean on the TV, with 4-player mode, or you can also use it on... I think in the carryable mode it also supports it. But yes, you can also play these card games on this system in the 4-player split screen. And now you already got two controllers with one, so you only need two more controllers. And I think these are much cheaper than the some kind of like a new, brand new PS5 or PS4 controllers. I presume that much. And here is, by the way, I'm basically making myself into a Nintendo fanboy with all this stuff. So I am a Pokemon fanboy on some degree. The Pokemon games that I really like or have really played a lot are the Pokemon TCG, which is the card game, physical or digital or in the tabletop simulator, and then Pokemon Go, but nowadays I don't really play that, but I still kind of dig a lot about the TCG. But I might maybe try maybe a used copy of some of these what's it called? Switch, not Wii U from the Goombo. But anyway, there's a good karting game. One of the only reasons to even own a PS3. Mod Nation Racers, really good game. Also a traditional karting game, but here you can compare the size of the kart. So it's kind of like a same height, but the game is so small. It's like a SD card, but here you can see that there's the actual real. There's even the notebook and the disc, but here don't even have any book, so I think it's only digital. But anyway, it's a modern day version. But it's one of the PS3 versions. I have the PS3 up there on the shelf also. It's still working. I bought it as used, but this is a new one. So this is a collections edition, whatever. But this is also still a really good game, even though the loading times are insane in this one. But anyway, some proofs that I am a karting gamer indeed. And so now I'm this stuff here makes me look like a total Nintendo fanboy, but I also really am more like a PS1 fanboy. There's a proof of it. I have a deluxe Crash Bandicoot 2 figure to show some proofs here. I bought it from the last GameStop sale that they closed the GameStop stores in Finland permanently, so they don't have these stores to sell anything anymore. But they actually have this hoverboard also from the Crash Bandicoot 2. You can also, this is really good, you can turn around these things and even move these kind of like wires here and stuff. And this also actually floats on water, I tested. And you can play some miniature racing game with this, even though it's not CTR, but anyway, I need to get the CTR for this console. And also there's some more proof. There's a lightning set for USB, so you can put up this to your PC and then you can get some PlayStation Lightning with this and stuff. I got a lot of little nerd stuff, gaming related items like this. So I'm just showing it a little bit so that you can get a little bit of I got this from my little brother as a Christmas gift. I think it was back in the same year that we played the CTR Nitro Fueled on the recording in 2019 or something. My other little brother still has that game. So we might play that more at some point. And yeah. What should I show? Let's see. Did I show everything that I can show about? It's a quick test to do some unboxing. But now you can see that it really looks cool. It has the same color. Purple is also this guy here that I bought from the Tokyo back when I went to Japan. This is bought from Akihabara in Tokyo, Japan. So this is what I really actually bought myself, and these others are just bought from internet store like through eBay and stuff. But yeah, I'm thinking this is a freestyle recording, so I'm trying to figure out what did I have to say. Okay, so yeah, so this is actually the screen, I think. This is the OLED screen, yeah. So now one of the differences is that you can see that there's a different kind of ventilation. Just yesterday I tried the original version. There's a different kind of ventilation shaft here, and the buttons are also kind of different. So I think it's a little bit bigger and heavier, and also the screen ratio is bigger, so it shows a little bit bigger screen, and I think it uses less battery and it has a brighter, better image or something. So this is an overall better value. It's the best version of the Nintendo Switch that you can get. And so I'm actually really happy about it. There you can connect it with something. And I'm not sure what else can I show, except I think you got all the wiring intact in the game, that you can just plug it in and start playing. And I think my Nintendo account from the mobile game that I tried. I tried some crappy mobile Mario Kart, but I really didn't like that one on my cell phone. It sucked. So you need to get this physical games, and I really can't actually wait to try out these games with four player LAN mode, that we could go to talk show and try to film. Everybody has their own Wii U, but Switch, and then they have their own copy, and you can use like four players can do the same thing, and then they all play on their own screen, and then they can also go all into the same internet match, and that's a really neat thing that you can do. So I really need to try out that kind of thing. And yeah, so this is covered in the Pokemon stuff. It's like a collector's graffiti stuff. I think this is, I don't even know the Pokemon's because it's all new. About one bad thing about this collector's edition is that you don't actually get the game with it. There's no game, but it's only the graphics. But I still got this collector's edition for a quite good price, so I'm happy about it, and it looks better. And the team colors for my characters, I also usually I use in the Doom Coop or my games that we play on, so on my channel I usually use this dark purple. It's kind of like my own team color. That's why I use it on all the Twitch site and stuff, if you have noticed it. But anyway, I think I can't really use so much more. You can put it here to make the big controller. But yeah, I need to start playing around with this. So thanks for watching, and let me know what you think and stuff. But I might do more kind of like these similar videos later on. I can show you a bunch of new things, like figures and collection stuffs and all that kind of cringy nerd stuff that I got lying around, or maybe some unboxing of that stuff or something. But I got a lot of stuff, the kind of interesting nerd stuff that you might wanna see. So Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more, and peace out. Let me know what you think and stuff. Okay.